After more than 2 weeks of waiting, sustained towering lava fountains finally returned at Hawaii's Kilauea Volcano. These lava fountains peaked at a sustained height of approximately 800 feet or 244 meters, occurring at around 9:27 a.m. on January 12th. This means that at that moment, more than 100 tons of molten rock every second were ejected upwards initially at a speed of approximately 154.7 miles per hour or 249.1 kilometers per hour. These lava fountain heights remained at approximately the same level for multiple hours, drawing in large crowds as lava spectacularly and harmlessly erupted within the southwest section of Kilauea's summit caldera. The first eruptive episode of 2026 at Kilauea was ongoing, marking its 40th such cyclical eruptive episode that ended in towering lava fountaining since December 23, 2024. Due in part to near stationary winds, buoyant gas in the eruption plume rose straight upwards, reaching heights of 13,000 feet or 3,962 meters. Small tephra rained down in front of one of the webcams, as you can see here. This primarily involved lightweight articulate and Pele's hair, but mostly the former. But how did Kilauea get to this point? After all, for 16 days following its Christmas Eve to Christmas Eve eruptive episode, no lava flows occurred and all that was visible was a weak orange glow from its two summit vents at night. Then, January 9th marked the resumption of gas pistoning and minor lava flows from Kilauea's two vents. More than a dozen of these occurred across portions of the next 3 days, in one case originating from the south vent to feed a 1 kilometer or approximately 3,000 foot long lava flow. Then, on January 12th, spattering from the north vent increased at 6:30 a.m. local time, becoming a continuous angled stream of lava 30 minutes later. Not much change occurred for the next 70 minutes until, at 8:13 a.m., something changed. The magma supply to Kilauea's north vent dramatically increased, causing a much greater volume of molten rock to spill out and overflow beyond the magma conduit. Rapidly escalating, continuous vertical lava fountains developed, and by 15 minutes later, these had reached a sustained height of 70 feet. These further increased to a height of 100 feet at 8:40, 170 feet at 8:50, and 330 feet at 9 a.m. Only an hour after sustained lava fountaining began, sustained heights of 650 feet were achieved. The peak lava fountain heights were then reached during the same hour, and while all of this was occurring, the south vent remained fairly inactive, only weakly erupting. For much of the last year, almost all of Kilauea's tallest lava fountains occurred specifically from its south summit vent, so the lack of activity there might explain why yesterday's lava fountains ranked only in the middle of the pack in terms of maximum height reached during Kilauea's 40 recent eruptive episodes. Perhaps the lava, which would have erupted from the south vent, was already emitted via numerous smaller lava flows in the 3 days leading up to the north vent's lava fountains, or maybe for whatever reason most of the rising magma and gas was funneled into only the north vent and its associated underground plumbing. While the amount of lava Kilauea's recent eruptive episodes have produced has continued to increase, so has the average amount of time between each eruptive episode. As a result, if this trend continues, I expect Kilauea's 41st episode of sustained lava fountaining to begin sometime between January 23, 2026 and February 6, 2026. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.